Hello, good morning. Welcome to our virtual children's church. I'm really glad that we have technology to help me to be able to be with you this morning, even when we can't be together at church. We're going to continue class today. And just as a reminder, we are doing one lesson for all three of our JBMDL Protestant children's church services. So we are joining together today on the Gospel Project, Unit 19, Lesson 5, Jesus as a Child. So let's get started today with the special song that I picked for you guys that reminds us how God is always with us, even in uncertain times. For you, I encourage you to back up the video, listen to it again, so you can think about those words. I love some of the phrases in that song. It says, God is faithful, He is true, He is always with us, He never changes. No matter what's going on in your life, you know that God will always be there and always be the same. It's one of my favorites. We're going to sing one more song today, and you know this one. This is To God Be the Glory, and this is the song I hope that one day when we get to meet back together again, we'll be able to sing this song as a children's choir for the adults in the service. So you know this one. Sing out nice and loud. Nice job. Thanks for singing with me. Now, let's get our Bibles out and start our Bible lesson. If you know how to read, get a Bible with all the words in it. Look it up for yourself and read it along with me. If you need a minute to pause the video, go find a Bible, do that, come back. We're going to be opening our Bibles to Luke chapter 2, verse 41. So find that so you can read it along with me. Luke 2, 41. It says, every year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the festival of the Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went up to the festival according to the custom. After the festival was over, when his parents were returning home, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem, but they were unaware of it. Thinking he was in their company, they traveled on for a whole day. Then they began looking for him among their relatives and friends. When they did not find him, they went back to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days of looking, they found him in the temple courts, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. Everyone who heard him was amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. Remember, it had been 4 days since they had seen their son, and he was only 12 years old. His mother, that's Mary, said to him, "Son, why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been anxiously searching for you." Sounds like a mother, doesn't she? And then Jesus answered in verse 49, "Why were you searching for me? Didn't you know I had to be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he was saying to them. So when he said father's house, he was talking about God. God. He was talking about God. He wasn't talking about his father, Joseph, which is what they were thinking of. Like, we were on our way back to your father's house and you didn't come with us. They didn't understand. But then in verse 51, it says that he went back to Nazareth with them and was obedient to them. But his mother treasured all these things in her heart. And Jesus grew in wisdom and in stature and in favor with God and man. When it says at the end, Jesus grew in wisdom and stature, that means his brain grew and his body grew, just like all of us. Because our main point for this unit is Jesus God or human? Well, we know that Jesus was fully God and fully human. So just like a human, his brain grew and his body grew. Here's a fun activity you can do with your family to go along with this Bible story. Look up some baby pictures of you, of your parents, maybe even of your grandparents, and see the differences when you were a baby, maybe as a toddler, as you grew up, and think about the things that you learned how to do at different stages. When you were a baby and you first learned how to walk, it was really exciting. And as you learned how to read, maybe when you were 5 or 6, and then you learned how to ride a bike, you learned, I don't know, all kinds of things that you know how to do. So you stop and think about something that you know how to do that you've learned and how you've grown. And also think ahead. What would you like to be able to do as you grow older? What could you even learn how to do this week? What might take you a little bit longer? You might have to be able to be bigger to learn how to do it, like drive a car. Well, I brought a special picture. You can see it in the corner here. I wanted to show you this to you because this is a baby picture from our family. Ooh, move it so you can light. This is Mr. Guillaume when he was a baby, and we have this really big picture of him that we have in our house that he had done when he was a baby. He's so cute, isn't he? And he looks a lot like Liam, I think, my boy Liam, and his baby pictures are really similar. So you try this with your parents. Find some pictures of you when you were younger and some pictures of your parents and other people in your family. See who you look like. See how you have grown. Put that back down. All right. Now, while Jesus was growing up, he was focused on following God's plan, and we can do that too. He obeyed his parents, he told others about God, and those are things you can do even from your home. You can practice following God's way, the things that God wants you to do and learn as you grow up. Let's go ahead now and watch our Bible video about this story.
After Jesus was born, wise men followed a star to Bethlehem to find the new king of the Jews. The wise men worshiped Jesus as king. When they left, an angel told Joseph in a dream to leave Bethlehem because King Herod wanted to kill Jesus. So Mary, Joseph, and Jesus went to Egypt until Herod died.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Then they went back to Israel and lived in Nazareth. Jesus grew up in Nazareth. Every year, Jesus' parents traveled to Jerusalem for the Passover feast. Passover was the biggest holiday for the Jewish people. Many people traveled to Jerusalem to celebrate and remember when God saved his people from slavery in Egypt. When Jesus was 12 years old, Jesus and his family went to Jerusalem together. When it was time to go home, Mary and Joseph began traveling to Nazareth with a large group of people. They didn't notice that Jesus was not with them. They thought he was among the group of travelers. But Jesus was not with the group. He had stayed behind in Jerusalem. Mary and Joseph had been walking for a whole day when they started to look for Jesus. They looked among their relatives and friends, but they could not find him. So Mary and Joseph went back to Jerusalem. They searched everywhere for Jesus. The city was so big and Jesus was just a boy. Finally, they found him at the temple. Jesus was listening to the teachers and asking them questions. Everyone who heard Jesus could hardly believe how much Jesus understood. When Jesus' parents saw him, they were surprised. Mary said, "Son, why have you done this? Your father and I were worried. We've been looking everywhere for you." "Why were you looking for me?" Jesus asked. "Didn't you know that I had to be in my father's house?" But Mary and Joseph did not understand what Jesus was talking about. Then Jesus went back to Nazareth with Mary and Joseph. Jesus was always obedient to them, and Mary remembered all of these things. As Jesus grew up, he became even wiser. God was pleased with him, and so was everyone who knew him. God sent Jesus to earth with a purpose, even as a child. Jesus wanted to honor God. God blessed Jesus as he got ready to follow his Father's plan to die on the cross and rescue people from sin.
God's plan for Jesus was to live a perfect life, grow up, and die on the cross to save us from our sins. He forgives us when we ask him to, and he gives us his free gift of eternal life. Thanks for watching this with me today. But one more thing we're going to do. I forgot last week. We needed to work on our memory verse. The memory verse for this unit is John 1, 1 through 2. And I know some of you, you're in my Sparkies class on Wednesday, you've learned this one. So if you still have your Bibles out, go ahead and find it. Some of the words in your Bible may be a little different than the ones in mine. But this is what I have, and then we're going to sing our memory verse song to go along with this to practice the words a little bit better. So John 1, 1 through 2. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Now, in this verse, when it says the Word, that's talking about Jesus. So it's saying that Jesus was in the beginning. He was with God in the beginning, and he is God. So go ahead and we're going to sing with me, sing the memory verse song, and I bet you'll know the whole verse by the time we finish the song.
In the beginning was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
The Word was with God.
And the Word was God.
The Word was God.
He was with God in the beginning.
John 1:1-2.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
He was
1:1-2.
John 1:1-2.
All right, do you know it? Are you ready to say it with me? My kids have joined us. Let's say John 1:1-2. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. All right, the last thing I have to show you today before we're done is our activity pages. Now, these are available online. Send me a message. I'll get you the link so you can have them too. Our preschool page today, they have a seek and find. They need to find where Jesus is in the temple and Mary and Joseph. Also along the side, you know where he is? Where is he? Don't tell everybody. Okay. Now on the side too, for the parents, there's family discussion questions. One of the activities in here is to take a walk together as your family, just like Mary and Joseph did with Jesus. Now, they walked 150 kilometers from Nazareth to Jerusalem. So if you've ever done a 5K, they had to do 150K. It took them many days, many, many days. If you Google that, the distance from Nazareth to Jerusalem, it actually tells you it is a 30-hour walk. Wow. So don't take a walk that long, but take a walk with your family. That's one of the activity suggestions on here. The kids also have a coloring page. Our younger kid pages are right here. I've got Liam showing me these. Again, the color page. Ivy, can you see? You got a color page? And they have, upside down, a treasure chest. This is where you can draw something that is a treasure for you. Maybe even a treasure, that something that you treasure that you could give Jesus. And the last set I have back here is my bigger kids. Here's my big kid, Lily, back here. They have a special page with the Bible story text on it and then a journal where they can write some things they've learned from the story. And also a maze. Yes, they have a maze with our lesson point. And they have a section. I'll tell you later. Hang on. And then we have a section here on from different ages of your life, things that you can learn how to do or things that you did learn how to do at those times. And I hope that will provide a little bit extra application for those Bible truths in your family's home this week. Now, the last thing we're going to do, turn the page so I don't miss anything. We're going to close out by singing one of our favorite songs from our PWC preschool class as a benediction of sort for you guys today. So this is Deuteronomy 31:8. You remember this one, Ivy? Deuteronomy 31:8. Okay. If you know this one, sing it with me. This week, that the Lord is with you. He will not leave you or abandon you. All right, have a wonderful rest of your day and goodbye. Say goodbye.
Bye-bye. Bye.